Good morning. And welcome to the Church of St. Patrick. Today we celebrate the fourth Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our second collection is to help support Catholic relief services. Thank you for your generosity to this cause. Please take a bulletin home with you weekly. It lists all our parish activities for the month. Please make sure our cell phones are silenced before we begin our liturgy. Today's readings of the Old Testament and the New Testament offer rich material for reflection on how Christians are called to respond to God's word and authority in their everyday lives. In today's gospel, so compelling were Jesus' words and actions that the news about him could not be contained. 2,000 years later, the news about Jesus continues to spread. We are called to participate in sharing the good news of Jesus with others in our words and in our deeds. People should see in our lives the power and authority of God at work. We remember at this Mass William Norton. Our presider is Father Barnabas. Our gathering hymn is number 681, God Has Spoken by the Prophets, hymn number 681. Please stand and join the singing.
Therefore, I ask that Spirit of the Lord. love everyone in truth of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses spoke to all the people, saying, "A prophet like me will the Lord your God raise up for you from among your own kin. To him you shall listen. This is exactly what you requested of the Lord your God at Horeb, on the day of the assembly, when you said, 'Let us not again hear the voice of the Lord our God, nor see this great fire any more, lest we die.' And the Lord said to me, 'This was well said. I will raise up for them a prophet like you from among their kin, and will put my words into his mouth. He shall tell them all that I command him. Whoever will not listen to my words which he speaks in my name, I myself will make him answer for it. But if a prophet presumes to speak in my name, an oracle that I have not commanded him to speak, or speaks in the name of other gods, he shall die.'" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lift to day you hear his voice.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I should like you to be free of anxieties. An unmarried man is anxious about the things of the Lord, how he may please the Lord. But a married man is anxious about the things of the world, how he may please his wife, and he is divided. An unmarried woman or virgin is anxious about the things of the Lord, so that she may be holy in both body and spirit. And a married woman, on the other hand, is anxious about the things of the world, how she may please her husband. I am telling you this for your own benefit, not to impose a restraint upon you, but for the sake of propriety and adherence to the Lord without distraction. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Today, as we celebrate the 40th Sunday in the ordinary time of the year, the readings are inviting us to reflect upon listening to Jesus, who teaches us with authority. In the first reading, Moses speaks to the people, telling them, "The prophet is coming. The prophet will come, who will teach you with authority." And so when he comes and teaches you, then listen to him. More major shift simply because people at that time, people in the Old Testament, the Israelites, looked at Moses as the great teacher. Looked at Moses as their teacher. And so everything that they learned and kept always made a difference. Moses taught us. This is what Moses taught us. And so they looked at him as a teacher. But here Moses says to them, I am not. Someone else greater than me is coming, and he will teach you with the authority. And so listen to him. And that's what they make a major shift as we go to the gospel today. That prophet of whom Moses spoke about is Jesus. And so Jesus comes, here he goes into the synagogue and began to teach. And as they were listening to him, they were all surprised. They were amazed. And who is this? Look, here Jesus goes to the synagogue. He's a young man. He's in his early 30s. And yet, he's teaching them greater things with affirmation, with authority, and the scribes, and sitting listening to him, they're like, who is this? Where does he get all this stuff? He's teaching with authority. And not only that, among the crowd, there's someone who had an evil spirit. All of a sudden, he cries out, Jesus of Nazareth, have you come to destroy us? And Jesus looks at him and says, quiet, come out of him. And then he was put to left. And again, people in the crowd, in the synagogue, they're amazed. Not only that he's teaching the authority, but he has the power to drive out demons, evil spirits. And they were all amazed. And as they are leaving the synagogue going home, they were to talk about what they saw and what they had. And so the fame of Jesus continued to grow in the entire region of Galilee. A great prophet is teaching with authority. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, we are the ones who have the benefit or beneficiary, if you want to use that word, of this great prophet is teaching. We benefit from the teachings of Christ, who teaches us every day with authority. And if he does, what must we do? We listen to his teachings. And once we listen to his teachings, then our life is transformed. Will we are informed by the teachings of Christ, in that every day when we live, then we live as people who have been taught by someone with authority. And if we are taught by someone with authority, then we have no doubt. We have no doubt to say, well, is this true or not? No, no, he says, I am teaching you with authority because I have the authority to teach. And so Jesus does. And every day he teaches us when we listen to the word of God. At the end we say thanks be to God because he's teaching us. And so brothers and sisters, we are taught by him who has authority. What happens then? St. Paul says in the second reading, once we have accepted his teachings, then we are more concerned with the things of heaven, not the worldly things, because the worldly things come to an end, but the heavenly things will always last. And so our desire is to deepen that understanding and the awareness of the heavenly things. So Paul says, yes, we are living this world, and what are the things that are important for our day-to-day life, let us not lose sight of the heavenly things. And so how do we learn about the heavenly things? Back to Christ himself, in the Holy Scriptures. He teaches us, he speaks to us. But then, a warning is given to us. What happens, what must we do when we hear his voice, when we hear teaching us? The psalmist, from where, of course, you get the responsorial psalm, says, if today you hear his voice, harden not your heart. If today you hear his voice, harden not your heart. My dear brothers and sisters, how often do we hear the voice of the Lord? Many times. Either when the word of God is proclaimed, as it has happened to us today, or maybe just as we take a passage from the Holy Scripture and you read, and the God speaks to you, or maybe you are in a very quiet atmosphere for private prayer, and the God speaks to you. And so he does that all the time. But then, what happens when we hear him speaking to us? The big temptation is to harden our hearts. What are some of the practical examples in our lives? The Lord says to us, love one another. And he says that with authority, love one another. On the contrary, we find ourselves not truly loving one another. Why do I keep grudges against a neighbor? Why do I hate that particular person? If indeed the Lord says, love one another. It's a teaching. The Lord says, forgive one another as I have forgiven you. And yet we hear that, on the contrary, we harden our hearts. If someone wrongs me, I don't forgive, because I've not yet opened up my heart. Why do I keep anger in my heart? Why do I hate that particular person? When the Lord says, forgive one another. Or maybe the Lord says, share what you have with those who are in need. And yet, how often time do we do that with a generous heart? So the psalmist is saying to us today, if you hear his voice, harden not your heart. And so many brothers and sisters, it's a great privilege for us for the chance to hear the Lord speaking to us every day, every moment of our life. As I say, whether the scriptures proclaim it to us, or maybe you're in a private prayer at home, or perhaps in somewhere just doing a deep meditation, and the Lord speaks to you, and yet we don't fully open up our hearts and do what the Lord is calling us to do. Instead, we harden our hearts. Today he says, do not. Do not harden your hearts. Why? Because he teaches us with authority. We shouldn't have a doubt of his teachings. And so today, let us continue to pray for ourselves and to pray for each one of us, for our brothers here and out there, that we all heed to the teachings of Christ. We may learn from what is teaching us and faithfully live by his teachings. We shouldn't allow the worldly things to corrupt us, if you like, or maybe to mislead us from what the Lord is teaching us, but rather we rely on his word and follow what Jesus teaches us, not what the world offers. Because the world does not teach with authority. The world will give the opinions. But Jesus doesn't give an opinion. He teaches with authority. And so it's to him we say, yes, Lord, we are here to listen to you. We love to follow what you teach us. And the Lord God, open up our hearts that every day we hear your word. May our lives be transformed and live as people who have been taught by you simply because you teach us with authority.
They will continue to be strengthened by the glory of Jesus at work through them. Lord, in your mercy, that men and women in positions of trust seek justice and peace in all they do. Lord, in your mercy, that we may open our hearts to receive more fully all of God's simple and abundant blessings. Lord, in your mercy, that God's grace will help all in our faith community to affirm the dignity of every person, especially the unborn, the elderly, the refugee, and the poor. Lord, in your mercy. That God will bring healing of mind and body to all who are sick and those who have asked us to pray for them. Lord, in your mercy. That all who have died marked with the sign of faith, those who have died unremembered and unmourned, and especially Deacon Jack Work, may they feast at the heavenly banquet in the kingdom of the Lord. Lord, in your mercy. That William Norton, who we remember at this Mass, will always share in the eternal banquet. Lord, in your mercy. And for all these petitions, we hold deep in our hearts. Lord, in your mercy.
God, we know that your words are living and effective. Be and enhance our prayers. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Please join in singing our preparation hymn number 624, Jesus Christ by Faith Revealed, hymn number 624.
By his suffering, cancel out our sins, and by his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so the company of angels and the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end, we are glad. In a similar way, taking the chalice he gave the fruit of the vine, he gave thanks, and he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from me. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you before many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." grant you new life and kindness to all who partake of this one bread and one chalice, that gathered in one body by the Holy Spirit, they may truly become a living sacrifice of Christ to the praise of your glory. Therefore, Lord, remember now all for whom we offer this sacrifice, especially your servant Pope Francis, our bishop and the whole order of the bishops and all the clergy, those who take part in this offering, those who gathered here before you, your entire people, and all who see you with a sincere heart. Remember also those who have died in the peace of your Christ and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. To all of us, your children, grant your grace to the Father that we may enter into the heavenly inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, our spouse, the Blessed Apostles and the Saints in your kingdom, there with all the whole of creation, freed from the corruption of sin and the dead, may we glorify you through Christ our Lord, who whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Join in singing our communion hymn number 774, Be Not Afraid, hymn number 774.
Thank you. brief announcements for our parish family. We've had two deaths this week in our parish, so we pray for the repose of soul of Ann McGowan. Her funeral will be on Tuesday. And for Margaret Eckley, who passed away yesterday, she is the wife of Henry. And so we pray for the family that they may be comforted during this time of grief. Bishop Schlert has chosen our parish and Assumption BBM to visit during Catholic Schools Week. He will be here for the school mass at 9:30 a.m. on Wednesday. All are welcome to come and share the liturgy with our bishop, Bishop Schlert, this coming Wednesday, 9:30 a.m. The next parish retreat meeting is scheduled for this Monday, January 29th at 6 p.m. Our parish retreat will be held at the Convent of the Sisters of Providence in Elberson. Our retreat is scheduled for June 7th to the 9th. The fourth drawing of the Shamrock 10K will be for $1,000 and will be drawn this coming Saturday, February 3rd. Shamrock chances are available in the parish office or in the back of church. The next spaghetti dinner is next Sunday, February 4th. Please join us for a hot, delicious meal. Our Cooks with Collars video is live and it's on the Cooks with Collars website. Please look for St. Patrick's Church and help us out by giving a donation. All donations will stay in the parish. Currently, well, we moved up one, we're at 32, 32nd place. We can do better, I think. You can give your donation online or in the parish office or in the collection. At this time now, our altar service will come forward with the basket, and all our young people who have the mass cards, please come forward. Last week, we will be taking a survey in our parish and all the churches and dioceses of Allentown between February 14 and March 27. The survey will only be available during these dates, and we will ask you to reflect on your own spiritual growth and we will need to provide feedback on what our parish is doing to help you grow. It will be available online and in paper format with more instructions to follow. Again, that's February 14th through March 27th. Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our God, the Master's name.
Thanks be to God. Saint Michael, the angel, defend us in battle. We are protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke you from your prayer, and you do not embrace the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into the Satan, among the evil spirits, who are out of the world, seeking to remove souls.
One final announcement, and that is our volunteer appreciation luncheon is immediately after Mass today. There is plenty of food, so if you didn't get a chance to sign in, don't worry. Please join us for this luncheon as we give thanks and stand in appreciation for all our volunteers here at St. Pat's.
Please join in singing our recessional hymn number 586, Jesus, Her Redeemed Compassion, hymn number 586.